Yo, what's good, Legit Nation? Welcome back to another video on my channel, Legit Tim Vlogs. Today, we're gonna be taking a look at my sneaker collection, my own personal sneaker collection that I've collected throughout all the entire years. So if I own a sneaker, you guys are gonna see it today. I know that I've been getting a lot of requests of you guys wanting to see my own personal sneaker collection, so I'm bringing it back once again, except on this channel, because as you guys know, on the main channel, there's nothing but bangers on there. Originally, I started this channel to be a dope vlog channel with my friends, but it's really hard to get a hold of them, especially when they're always at work or school. So we're gonna start to put up some bangers on here. There will be more vlogs, but expect bangers. So if you're not already, make sure and hit that subscribe button. Without further ado, let's get straight into it. So as y'all guys know, we just moved into a new house and I got my very own closet now. Now it's not really that big. It's not as big as you would think that I would have, especially since I'm into sneakers, clothing, and hats, but it's all I really need. I went ahead and gave my girl the big, big, big closet. So don't ever say that I never did anything for her. We're gonna get straight into the closet, man. I honestly really don't have too much, if I'm being honest with y'all. I used to have a whole lot more when I was more into like streetwear and fashion and all that, but I'm not really into it as much anymore. So I'm not only gonna look at my sneaker collection, I want y'all to take a look at my entire closet. So come on in, come on in. It's not that big, bro. If you look at it, I can barely stand in here. Like, it's under the stairs right here and it gets smaller over here. I have all my sneakers over there. Oh, just a sneak peek. Don't even get it. Don't try to look over there, man. That was just a sneak peek. So what do I wear on the daily? It gets really, really, really hot in Texas. So pretty much on a daily, I'm over here wearing a jersey. But before we get into the jerseys, we got the belts. We got all the designer belts, MCM, Louis Vuitton. This one is my absolute favorite. It's the reliable one. It's super good quality. We got the Gucci belt, and then we got the plain brown belt, black belt from Walmart, because occasionally I forget my designer belt and I have to buy a belt from Walmart. Normally on the daily, I'm wearing some jerseys. So I got Champion, I got the Lakers, Kobe. Shout out to Black Mamba, bro. Kobe Bryant, RIP. We got Anthony Davis. We got Magic Johnson, the OG with the Mitchell Ness. I don't like the way that feels. We got a fake Bape Lakers. Why do I even have this in here? Because Sneaker Talk brought it to me and I didn't know what to do with it. We got some more Nike. We got the GOAT Michael Jordan Bulls right here. This one was $400. Beth gave it to me for Christmas. Big shout out to Beth. I love that one. We got the vintage NBA David Robinson. We got the Champion. We got a Bape. We have a Nike, another Nike. We got Zion Williamson from the New Orleans Pelicans, man. If y'all know, y'all know. Kyrie Irving from last year. Supreme jersey. We got Giannis, my boy, my favorite player in the NBA. Giannis Antetokounmpo. Y'all don't know about him. Y'all know about him now, man. We even got the All-Star. We even got the Freak merch on the side. We even got his jersey on right now. That's how much I mess with my boy Giannis, okay? And then we got other shirts in here. We got a little bit of Bape. You know what I'm saying? A little bit of Murakami. You know what I mean? Murakami Takamashi. And I don't know what I'm saying. We got Jordan. We got Jordan. We got Supreme CDG. We got a little bit of the Burberry. So you know what I mean? I didn't come from riches, so I don't have the best stuff. But what I do have is stuff that I've really worked hard for. The Supreme. We got the Off-White. You got some custom hoodie that I made. Most of the time though, you'll just see me in regular Champion, honestly, because like I have designer stuff and I love designer stuff, but I'm not necessarily wearing it all the time. Most of the time you're just catching me in like some Champion or whatever, because I'm just like, whatever, it's San Antonio, I don't got a stunt. We got all my hats up here, bro. I'm a big wearer of hats. Y'all see me wear hats in almost every video, which is why I cut my hair short, because I was like, it's annoying to wear hats with long hair. I'd rather wear it with short hair. We got the Cactus Jack hat right here. Spent $75 on that hat. Too much money. I like wear like this hat to the gym. Like, my uncle is an artist, local artist here. They go by Los Otros, and he designed these hats for the UTSA Roadrunner, so that's pretty dope. But other than that, man, we got some Supreme up here. Supreme, the regular Champion. We got the Gucci hat. This one I wear pretty much every day. So I ended up buying this hat for another YouTuber. I bought it for his birthday. I bought it for a birthday gift, and I ended up going back to the Gucci store because I was like, yo, I messed with that hat heavy, bro. And so I bought it for myself, and ever since then I wear it every single day. We got a custom YouTube hat up here. And yeah, man, it's pretty much basic hat. You got Supreme, Champion. I don't want to keep my hat section too long, but we also got like NBA Chicago Bulls Champion hat. This one I got from round two in LA. So yeah, man, I mean, we got a lot of hats, bro. Like, I'm really, really like addicted to hats. Like, this one's a Los Angeles Nike, pretty dope. Some Spurs, another Gucci, MCM, more of a designer look to it. Got a Gucci way in the back that I used to wear a long time ago. That's the shirt and the hats. When it comes to the pants, I'm normally rocking these pants that I got called G-Star Raw. All my life, I've always hated wearing pants. And then I started going to LA and I went to this store called G-Star Raw. I tried them on, man, and they pretty much changed my life. Like, I'm not even kidding with you. I spend about, what is it, like $200 a pair? Like $200 a pair on these jeans, but this is all I need. They're super comfortable and this is all I wear. But it's time to get into what you guys really, really care about, and that is the sneakers. So let's go ahead and start busting them out. I'm gonna go from probably the least hype to the most hype sneakers. So let's just get started with it. First of all, in the least hype sneakers, we got these Yeezy 700s right here. here. And honestly, these shoes are ruined because I got red paint on all of them when I was doing a hydro dip experiment. These are pretty beat, but I wear these pretty much the majority of my time. I would say they're one of the top three most comfortable sneakers in my collection. Super simple. I didn't expect to buy them. I bought them out of impulse, and I just can't stop wearing them because they're super comfortable with the boost, and you can just match them with everything. Nike Air 270s. These sneakers, I remember when they first came out, everybody was crazy about them. I felt like I had to pick up a pair because I loved them. I bought them like, what, 3 years ago? And I really don't wear them anymore, but they're a really dope colorway, black, white, and gold. My three favorite colors when it comes to sneakers. So I had to cop them, man. For super not hype, but we got my running shoes right here. The Joyrides. These are the most comfortable running shoe ever. All my life, I've never wanted to run. I've always been scared of running. I've always been such a wimp to run. And when I started running, I started dropping the weight. I started looking 10 times better. And this Joyride technology, they have little balls on the insoles. Bro, this is life-changing right here. This pair of shoes changed my life. It got me fit. Gotta get into the basketball joints, man. My favorite player of all time, Giannis Antetokounmpo. His first pair that he ever made. My mom got me these for Christmas. Everybody asked me what I wanted for Christmas, and I said either 2K gift cards or some Giannis shoes, and my mom ended up coming through, surprising me with them. So this is my little collection I have built up. I also have a red pair that Sarah gave me. I don't know where they're at. Sorry, Sarah, if you're watching this, but this is my favorite player of all time. Kind of a cheap basketball shoe, but I love the way the shoe plays. Your boy's a little bit of a hooper. We might have to go to the hoop for some videos. Steph Curry, a lot of people hate on him, but I actually got sponsored for this one video. So we got the Steph Curry Sour Patch Kids collab. This is a pretty dope sneaker. I like the way it fits. I haven't broken them in yet, and I would have given them away to one of my boys because usually when I get free stuff, I usually give it away to my homies. But I just feel like this was such a dope collab and it was such a dope sponsorship. I just felt like I had to keep the shoe. So we got Sour Patch, we got Steph Curry. Thank you so much for sponsoring it, Under Armour. Moving on to Adidas. Now from here on out, you guys are just gonna see Heat. What I did recently is I sold all my GR shoes and I only kept the Heat. So from now on, we're only messing with the Heat, right? So we got, man, heating up, boy. Heating it up. The all red Adidas NMD. Human race is in the red colorway. This is just a grail for me. Something I had to have. I want the yellow ones, but they're super expensive. But I'm super glad I got these. Some of y'all, most of y'all, are gonna call me really stupid for this, but I traded my pair of off-white Jordan 1s in the blue colorway for these. But the off-white Jordan 1s I never wore. These, I wore the crap out of them. So if you ask me, I'd say I got my money worth, but these are going down and the off-white ones are going up. So I technically took a L on that one. Bam, in the black colorway, my only purchase that I've ever purchased from Flight Club. I told myself, man, Tim, I want you to just once go in LA, purchase a pair of shoes from Flight Club and walk out. I paid $2,000 for these, bro. $2,000. But I had to do it because it was a sponsored video. I had $2,000 to spend and I wanted to spend it in Flight Club. So shout out to Flight Club. These are really dope. I don't wear them as much anymore, but still a dope piece in my collection. My first ever pair of Yeezys, the Pirate Blacks right here. This shoe is old as it is. This is the oldest sneaker in my collection that I've had for so long, but they still look pretty good if you ask me. They still look in pretty good condition. So these will go with anything. They're super comfortable, and I actually took the dub on these because I traded them for the Don C Air Jordan 2s. If you guys know anything about that, the Don C Air Jordan 2s at the time, they were the same price as these. Those went all the way down, these went all the way up. So I took the W in this one. Couple years later, a sneaker that I never thought I would get, the Turtle Dubs. I ended up buying these from JC at Urban Necessities in Las Vegas. They were used, they were going for about $1,000. So normally I think these were going for like 2,500 and up or something like that. So I had to pull the trigger, I had to get them, and I wore these so much, dude. I wore these like every single day for like 6 months. So I did get my money out of these. My newest Adidas, or not my newest Adidas, my second newest Adidas, the Yeezy 700 V3 right here. This glows in the dark. Dope, dope, dope concept. Honestly, I'm not gonna lie. I don't like that it doesn't have any boost in it. It's the only Yeezy that doesn't have boost in it. And I paid way too much money. Went on Adidas.com. I tried to win them. I didn't win them. I got mad and I went to StockX and I spent $700 on these. They're not very comfortable. So I wouldn't recommend buying them unless you're in love with the look. Next, man, let's move it to Air Jordan. Actually, these right here, man. These Shawns, bro. This is a grail that I've been wanting for a very long time, and I finally ended up buying them. I don't like how they crease. I've only worn them a couple times, but they're already creasing. I bought these at Cool Kicks in LA. I bought them for my birthday cruise, and man, were these worth the money. I didn't think I would wear them as much as I do, but I wear these a lot, and they're one of my favorite sneakers in the collection, especially since I switched it out to the white laces. Paid about $1,200 for these, but like I said, I don't buy every sneaker that comes out anymore. I save my money for when I really, really really want something, and then I pull the trigger and I buy it. Sean Witherspoon, thank you. Watherspoon, Watherspoon, Wickerspoon. Bro, everybody critiques me for getting Sean's name wrong. I don't even know how to say it. Some people say tomato, some people say Sean Witherspoon. We got the Drake OVO 12s. This is another really old sneaker in my collection. I've had these for a while, but I had the 10s. I regret getting rid of the 10s, but I love the 12s, bro. White and gold. This is my favorite 12 of all time. What more do you need, bro? Like, this shoe is so fresh. It's already pretty much worn, but like I said, man, we wear our sneakers. Remember that. We wear our sneakers. Now it's time to come up with some more heat. We got the Travis Scott Air Jordan 1s. This is my favorite Air Jordan 1 of all time. Reason why, not because it's hype, not because it's Travis Scott, but when you put these on your feet, it feels some type of way. Like, it doesn't feel really cheap and flimsy like the regular Air Jordan 1s do. It feels really good. And they got a stash pocket, so I don't store anything in them, but a lot of people don't know it has this little stash pocket right here. So you can put some stuff in there if you want to put some stuff in there. But nah, I really like the material. Suede on the back, really good tumbled leather, and these shoes go with anything, so I really like them, man. They're really good quality. Big shout out to Travis Scott, and fun fact, I'm wearing the matching hat that goes with them. Bam. My first ever pair of Travis Scott's, we got the Travis Scott 4s. I didn't want these at first. I thought they looked really silly, and then when I saw them in person at Texas Shoe Exchange, I had to pull the trigger. I don't want to say my favorite 4 of all time, but top 3 favorite 4s of all time. I really like the Air Jordan 4. It's just really hard to wear these with stuff. It's really hard to wear this with anything, but I really do love this sneaker. It looks amazing in person. It looks amazing to my eyes. It's time to get into a little Off-White. So these, why did we buy these? I think we were doing some type of sneaker challenge or something. VidCon. We were going to VidCon and I needed a pair of sneakers to break out, to bust some necks. This one I've only worn literally one time. I'm not going to lie. It's really hard to wear these sneakers with something, but I wanted my first pair of Air Force Ones and I just happened to buy these because they were dope and they were hype and it looks really dope, but I don't wear these because it's hard to wear these with anything. So maybe I'll bust them out more at special events. I think I was trying to purposely not wear these so that way I can wear them whenever we do go to dope events. I do have a clean pair of shoes to wear because as you can see, I wear most of my kicks, so most of them get beat. So if I save these for a special occasion, I can bust out this shoe when I don't have anything else to wear. My most worn sneaker out of the entire collection. Reason why I sold all my non-hype sneakers. The Presto Off-White. These are beaters. These are my daily beaters, bro. Daily beaters. I wear these all the time. Most comfortable sneaker I've ever worn in my entire life. And they are hype. So you get those. You can wear them with anything. They're super comfortable, man. I saw some kid wearing them on the airplane when I was flying back from LA. And I decided to grab them because Cool Kicks gave me a really good price on them. And I really want more pairs of these. I really do. But they're really expensive and Beth won't let me buy anymore. Big shout out to you, babe, behind the camera for holding the camera.
Another shoe I probably regret buying. These big Balenciagas. I bought these to stunt. I bought these to go out when I'm in LA. And I paid too much for these. And they're really hard to wear. And they look funny on your feet. But I paid retail for these. But still, that was too much for these. These are a hard flex. A very, very hard flex. This is the type of shoe that you wear if you're gonna go out. And I mean out, out. We're almost getting to the end here, but I got these in Japan. I wore them a couple times. Balenciaga. I don't really wear these too much, but I got them for like half price in a Japanese thrift store. So I was like, yo, that's a cop, son. Before I get to the heat, my most expensive sneakers, I gotta give some honorable mentions. This is pretty much everything in here, but some new cops that I just got. These Yeezy 500s. I just got them because I really wanted some more Yeezys that were dad shoes, and I really love those 700s, so I decided to buy these in a tan colorway. Feel like I can wear them with a lot of stuff. Haven't worn them yet, but I'm gonna start wearing them. I got them for a retail of only $200 from Nice Kicks. Pretty good cop. I think I'm gonna wear them a lot. I got really lucky off the Nike sneakers app, bro. If you know the box, you already know what it is. The Off-White Air Jordan 5s. I really didn't want them. I thought they looked really ugly from the picture, and I kind of still do think they look pretty ugly, but I got them for retail. I can't complain. I'll probably throw some white laces on them, and I'll probably try to rock them. Cool concept, Off-White, cool design, but let's get into the most expensive sneakers. So my second most expensive sneaker, this is a grail. This is a shoe that all throughout my life I've been wanting. The Yeezy 2s, soldiers right here. We got the pink, we got the green glow on the bottom. We got Kanye's shoe when he was with Nike, the Yeezy 2. These go from anywhere from $4,000 to $5,000 brand new, and I got them for only $2,000. Major steal. I don't wear these. I think I just see them and they're just so much money. So I'm just like, I don't want to like ruin them. I don't want to wear them. I don't know what it is. I can't, bro. I love these shoes too much. Last but not least, if y'all know me and my channel, y'all guys already know the grail, the lifelong dream sneaker, a sneaker that I never thought I would ever get in my life. A sneaker that they used to say, what's your grail, your dream sneaker? The Nike Air Max, bro, from Back to the Future. They only made about 800 pairs of these and I'm holding one in my hand. They're never gonna make these again. This is insane. I bought them for an expensive price, but these go for up to like $20,000. Dude, insane cop. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching my sneaker collection. More bangers on this channel pretty soon. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace, homie. Stay blessed. We're out of here.